So in in sword work, when he strikes down on my head, you'll see in movies this block right here. Well, this block is only partially correct. In movies, you'll see them do this and it stops the other person's sword, and that's horse crap. As he keeps pushing down, there's not enough leverage. If he just muscles it down, there's not enough strength in the wrist to keep all this leverage from closing in, right? So if he swings down, this makes a bridge to my shoulder and he slides off like that. So as he's swinging slowly, the block is partially correct so that it makes a bridge to my shoulder and then I'm on top, right? It redirects his strike. So as he's striking, it redirects his strike and I'm right here. The problem with standing in front of him is as he strikes, if I'm an inch too far forward with this, I miss my shoulder and he kills me. If I'm an inch too far back, I miss my shoulder and he kills me. So these are bad options. This is the proper placement for this also. I'll want to tilt my head as he's doing this. So as he comes in, I want to tilt my head so that I'm not like, hey, what's up? You know, and he kills me. So this is an umbrella. This is a secondary defense. The primary defense is as he swings, I'm not there. Right? I step off at my angle. So as he swings, I'm not in front of the sword. So as he swings, I go, boom, and he's dead and I'm not. So this angle is important because as he swings at my head and this closes down, this is pretty much the angle that we use for Aikido. So as he just uses his hand and swings Shomenuchi at my head, this causes him to kind of go off to the side and I'm on top, right? Whether it's that arm or this arm. So he comes up and I raise my arm up and I'm on top. Or taking his hand, he's gonna swing at my head and I'm on top. But it's the same angle because I'm not stopping his force and then starting it. I'm letting him glance down my arm so that I'm just continuing his motion with a sword. As he swings over my head, this is another one, I'm continuing his motion so that I'm on top. This position in Aikido is called Hasu no Kamae. And my elbow is slightly down. This is about a fist away from my mouth. The blade is out. And what happens is as he's swinging down at me, I'm moving his sword to the outside of my body, and I'm on top. So I can either be moving away from him and cutting his arm, or I can be moving toward him and cut through his head. But either way, I am moving this to the outside of me, right? And it doesn't really matter which side I go to. As he swings, I'm still on top of him, right? He's gonna swing, and I'm on top. So with the parrying motion of the sword, I will use what I call the wheel, and it kind of follows the gi line. It's very steep on either side, right? And it's a very circular type motion. So we're either raising the sword or we're cutting. And so it's like this. So it reaches out as far as I can. And it's constant. So I'm raising the sword, whichever side it is. So my hands create a wall. Just hold your hand up. So my hands create a wall between me and Uke. So if I'm over here, my hands are on this side of me. But it's a very steep thing. So I either raise the sword or I'm cutting, right? And when I will teach in these videos, I'm just going to say the wheel. And this is what I'm talking about. So the wheel, let's say he's punching at me, I want to redirect his energy up, right? If he puts his fist in my hand and he's pushing toward me, I don't want to fight him, but it takes no effort to steer him somewhere else. And up is always easy because nobody can get taller. So as he punches toward me, I want to raise it up and then bring it down like a tasa no kamae, right? So as he's punching in, I'm just steering him to the outside of me. So if he's gonna step through really hard, it kind of helps his energy go to the outside of me. So he's coming in, and I keep this all very narrow. I don't want my elbow all sticking out here so that it gets cut off or run into. I also don't want to push him to the outside of me. If I try to push him, his momentum is still coming this way. If I keep my hand very narrow, it takes his energy and directs it past me. So even though I haven't moved my feet as he's coming in, he passes me. Then I can move my feet. So I can raise the sword and cut. So as he's coming in, I'm raising and cutting. So I'm raising and cutting, all in one motion. So I'm raising the sword, girls, look. So I'm raising the sword. As I tenkan, I cut. And it just ends up in my hand. With the wheel, as he punches, I'm not committing to a technique, I'm just not getting hit. So he's gonna punch, and he's gonna punch like one, two, three, right? So one, two, three. It's just a continuous motion that keeps him from hitting me as I step up on an angle. So one, two, so he has to constantly change his angle to attack me again, and I'm constantly changing my angle to be better than his. So as he's coming in real hard and fast, all of a sudden I have a technique. So instead of committing to the idea of he's punching in at me, instead of committing to the idea of trying to grab him and do a technique, I'm not committing to any technique. I'm just not getting hit. And eventually, a technique will be there, right? So for cutting, as he's coming in to punch me, my hand's already up and I'm just cutting. But I'm just cutting. So let's say he's gonna do a one, two, three. So he's punching, punch, punch, and I'm still moving. And I can just kind of walk up his body. So he's coming in, punch, 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 right? And what you may see is that as he punches that first time, I actually hit him in the head, which just lines up. I'm not trying to hit him anywhere. I'm just not getting punched. Or if I'm backing, because I'm afraid of him, let's see. And then I have a technique there that just happened to get stuck in my elbow. I'm not grabbing him. Much better. I'm not grabbing him, but as I turn, it just happens to be in my hand. As I turn, it just happens to be in my hand. Without really committing to a technique in my head. Arrives, which I think is what Aikido